We start with the earth. أَلَمْ نَجْعَلِ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادًا. And then وَالْجِبَالَ أَوْتَادًا. The mountains on top of it is pegs. The earth, Quran describes, shifts. And the mountain puts it in place, holds it together. Now, the earth in Arabic is feminine, and the mountain is masculine. And the earth is also, the earth also gives birth. That's why it's called mihada too. Mahad is the cradle of a mother. And men are described as supporters of family and stability and tamkeen and, you know, sakina, etc., etc. Right? First, Allah describes that the earth and mountain are married. And immediately He says, men and women are married. وَخَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. Isn't that beautiful? Let's stick with that first one. The earth and the mountain are paired together. Think of it visually. A huge patch of land, and the most prominent thing is what? The mountains. If you go to the end of this passage, you see a huge sky, and the most prominent thing in that sky is what? The sun. So He starts with that, the large landscape, and then the thing that sticks out, and He ends with the large skyscape and the one thing that sticks out. That's how the passage begins and ends. Pair and pair. The second thing He mentioned was that He created man and woman in pairs. If we go on in reverse, backwards, He mentions وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ لِبَاسًا وَجَعَلْنَا النَّهَارَ مَعَاشًا. He made the night a garment, a covering. And He made the day a means of earning a living. And by the way, on the one hand He said man and woman, and on the other hand He compared them to night and day. Which is it's truly amazing. Other places in the Quran, Allah will say, وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَى, the night, وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا تَجَلَّى, the day, وَمَا خَلَقَ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى, and how marvelously He created the male and the female.